here in Athens, Greece, at a traditional Greek restaurant called Idrea, and they've agreed to show us how to make a dish very common to Greece called moussaka, only vegetarian. Come on, let's go check it out.
Welcome. Let's go back to the kitchen. Let's get started. So we've got, first thing first, we've got the ingredients. We're gonna need some carrots, some potatoes, some zucchini, and some eggplant. This is how fat our eggplant we want it to be.
Okay.
The same goes for our zucchini. We need some boiled carrots. 10 to 15 minutes will do. This is how fat we want them.
Okay.
Okay.
You fry this
in olive oil.
Okay.
For about 10 minutes.
Okay.
Then we take the slices, we spread them in some paper.
Okay.
Just take the lot of olive oil out.
Okay.
Don't want to be too moist on the inside.
Yep.
And then we make the layers.
Okay.
And then with the last and the hardest part, the bechamel sauce.
Okay.
And we got the vegetarian moussaka.
Great.
So, should we start?
Yes.
Much olive oil.
Okay.
We let
like
the olive oil.
Yeah.
Let's do the potatoes. We don't need to fry the potatoes or the eggplant all the way through. If we do that, it's gonna be too dry. This is how we want it to be.
Give us a little brown.
Yeah. And then we spread this on paper like this, and we're good to go.
Okay.
So our zucchini, gato. How we want it to be. We might overcook this piece a little bit.
Okay.
We don't mind with the zucchini.
Okay.
So the eggplant, this is the part where we're gonna be a little cautious. The eggplant could easily be destroyed and lose its consistency. And just because it's in the most important layer, we want them like this. This is a nice way to get the eggplant done. And now,
ready?
When the olive oil it starts to leave, then we take another empty container. We spread some titirin afto vasili.
Gouda.
We spread some grinded gouda in it.
Gouda cheese. Yes.
Gouda cheese. And then we make the first layer of our potatoes. I cannot stress enough, we don't want a lot of oil, we don't want a lot of fluids. It's gonna destroy the moussaka. It won't have any house of the
consistency.
Yeah, it's not gonna be there to get it. It's gonna destroy it. It's gonna be like a milkshake.
Okay.
And we don't want that in the moussaka. It must be firm, it must be like that, and it must be moist. It must be juicy on the inside. We spread another layer of Gouda cheese right above the potatoes. It helps with consistency. Then we use the nutmeg.
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg is the spice that makes the moussaka what it is. It gives it that special taste, that Greek part. Salt, of course. And then we spread some of our tomato sauce. We want its plus. We don't want to be even. We add the eggplant. You can see how dry we want them to be. Try to even it out a little bit. Not too much pressure. And now some more cheese. Everyone loves cheese. Nutmeg. Usually nutmeg goes to the first and the last and the one before last layer of our food. We don't want to put it too close to the heat in the middle, so it won't lose its aroma.
Okay.
A little more salt, a little more pepper, and then some more freshly grated tomato juice. Now we add our final layer before going to the good part, the zucchini. Add some more cheese. Some more tomato sauce. You can follow this process for the regular moussaka as well. And now we go to the vegetarian part, the interesting part.
Normally what would happen is you would put minced or chopped meat on there.
Yeah.
Is that
okay? And then now we will do the same process, but we're gonna use carrots.
Okay.
Great. So we'll spread the carrots. Nothing changes. This is how it should be before we add the bechamel. We could sprinkle it with a little more salt and pepper. because it's carrot, it's gonna enhance the flavor. First tomato sauce,
okay.
Some extra cheese, because you cannot be too steep with cheese, even it out a little bit. We don't need a lot of force.
Right.
This is almost done. We've got the carrots, we've got the zucchini, we've got the eggplant and the potatoes, we've got the Gouda cheese, nutmeg, salt, pepper, and fresh tomato sauce. Bechamel, it's our most important thing in the moussaka, like I said a million times. We're gonna need milk, flour, and butter to make it. We stir it up together, first the butter with the flour, we make it like a cookie dough. When it's nice and oily, we start adding the milk. We start stirring, we don't stop. If we stop, it's gonna get crunchy, it's gonna get ruined. And then we continue, we add some vegetable broth just to enhance the flavor, enhance the aroma, find our consistency. And when it's done, it's all evened out, it has a nice color. We take it and we spread it upon our moussaka.
So that's just boiled milk right now?
Now that's boiled milk. And now we've got for the bechamel, we're gonna need butter. This is the hardest part. This is why Greeks love their mothers and grandmothers so much. Regular white flour.
Now, can it be made with spelt or any other types of flour?
Yeah. The only difference is you're gonna have to experiment a little bit to find the proper consistency. We have some warm milk on the side. We let the butter melt a little bit. Some more salt. We need approximately for this quantity 300 kilograms and the same butter. For the bechamel, there is no proper quantity. It's actually practice and experience. As we can see here, it needs constant stirring. We need it to be a little like a cake. The more we stir, the more the butter sucks the flour in.
So it becomes like a dough.
Yeah, the first step is to get like this. Pour some more milk. As I said before, there is no proper quantity. Yeah. You have to have some experience with it. And now we pour the milk in. We stir around the edges. We don't want it to stuck. And now we stir. The more we stir, the more stable it's gonna get, the firmer it's gonna get. And when we get it to the proper consistency, we just pour it over our moussaka. You pour milk as wanted. In this part, you never leave your tools. You're not gonna stop stirring. If you stop stirring even for a moment,
it burns.
It's not the burning we're worried about. We want the flour and the butter to be totally mixed with our milk. If that doesn't happen, we're gonna get little flour in our bechamel, and we don't want that. I would recommend starting with medium and go from there.
Okay.
You're gonna need medium heat, and you might have to rise up the heat a little bit as you stir.
Okay.
We need it to become a little mushy, like here. We could use some vegetable broth to add some flavor in this step. As you can see, our bechamel is looking very good. The broth, we don't have to say that it's vegetable broth, since it's a vegetarian moussaka. Bechamel is ready, and now we just spread it up on our moussaka.
Now, could you use one of those whipper blender things?
You could, but if your moussaka is this, consistency is number one. It must be a straight, solid piece. Now, we put the bechamel up on top. You can see how evenly it spreads.
Now, what if you don't have this type of pan?
You won't have any problem.
Oh, okay.
Even in a round pan, the only thing it matters, it wouldn't hurt to be a little high.
Okay.
Because you need layers.
Yeah.
But moussaka can be this thin, it can be like a tower. It's
okay.
Not fixed. It's every woman in Greece makes the moussaka with slight differences than her mother or her grandmother. Believe it or not, moussaka is one of the recipes that no Greek person knew by reading. You have to do it, you have to make mistakes, you have to cook it again and again and again. But when you're done making the bechamel, you have Italian cuisine spread up in front of you. You can learn to do anything. Some people like to put some nutmeg on the first layer. We don't, we want it to be a little neutral. We don't want it to be too ethnic. We use some Parmesan cheese this time. We need something a little white and saltier. We want a nice layer cover our bechamel. The cheese will give it the color you all know, that crispy brown. And this is our moussaka. Half an hour, 180 degrees. It would be wise to check it every 10 minutes. Have the nice brown color in the Parmesan we add on top. Our moussaka is ready. Leave it 10 minutes to cook and we're good to go. It's all about the layers. You can have 6 layers of zucchini. You can have 1 layer of zucchini. It's up to you. We said before, moussaka cannot be described in just a book. You have to see it, you have to taste, you have to try. Every Greek cook, every Greek mother, every Greek grand, everyone makes it their own. Moussaka is a custom plate. Little differences, it's what makes it so great. You can have it this big, you can have it larger. It's not lasagna, it's not Italian. No one's gonna judge you for that. And this is our moussaka, all nice and ready. Now, you can see the color, you can see the texture, you can see what I've talked about a million times about firmness and consistency. The most important thing, you must let it rest for about, you must take a piece out and let it rest for about 10 to 20 minutes. Lose much of its heat, so we get that consistency.
Mm-hmm.
With its volume, what we want the moussaka to be. And now, Bill, I want you to go outside, find a nice table, and I'm gonna get you a small sample of Greek hospitality, just for you. A Greek plate of vegetarian moussaka. And I know that you don't drink alcohol, but you're in Greece now. And it would be a great insult if you didn't just have a glass of Greek beer alpha.
Well, I don't want to insult anybody.
So, cheers, it was great having you, and I hope you and your fans enjoy our vegetarian moussaka.
Alright, let's give it a shot. So good! I love it, it's amazing. You suggest to eat it with a Greek salad.
And beer. You
and
can't
beer.
Have Greek lunch without salad, bread and beer. This is the most typical Greek lunch that you can find in Greece. A plate of hot moussaka, salad, bread, and your family all together fighting and arguing at a table. That's Greece. That's a little part of Greece.
Perfect. Okay, well, I absolutely love this restaurant. Tell me the name of it.
Idria.
Idria.
You can find us in the center of Plaka.
It's a great little village, Plaka, where this is located. People walking around, all kind of shops. The restaurant is highly rated. I love the service. The food is incredible. I've been eating here almost every night and really enjoy it. So when you are in Greece, I will have a link for their website in the info box below and on the blog. And for more videos on health and wellness, don't forget to subscribe and check out the blog at theartofunity.com. Good luck with this.